the skies were sunny. The temperature, a comfortable 76 degrees. The place, the Rose Bowl, Pasadena, California. The occasion, Super Bowl 21, the spectacular climax to the professional football season. It has been called the Great American Timeout. Work ceases in every city and town. Thousands of parties are organized. The crime rate drops out of sight. Besides the 102,000 fans that are here, over 120 million more will see it on television. Without doubt, the single most important sports event of the year. The opponents, the New York Giants, and the Denver Broncos. Everyone's normal routine has been rescheduled to see these champions compete. There can be no greater honor or more thrilling experience than for a player to participate in this great contest. And what follows are a few highlights from that game and some comments by the champions. Their afterthoughts may not be what you would normally expect to hear from Super Bowl heroes.
That touchdown pass in the Super Bowl, the first thing that came to my mind was to thank God. So I knelt briefly and made the sign of the cross as a gesture of thanksgiving. A simple action that said thanks for my good fortune, to my teammates and coaches for preparing me for this moment, to the fans for their encouragement, to my family and friends for their love and understanding, but most of all, to God and my parents who gave me the greatest gift of all. Life. At the end of the game, all of the Giant players left the field champions. Now with the abortion death squads allowed to run rampant through our country, I wonder how many future champions will be killed before they see the light of day. The sign of the cross can be a symbol for many things. I use it now in prayer for the condemned unborn.
The score was 10-7 Denver. At this point, anybody's game. Then the Giants' senior defensive big play man stepped forward. And forward. And nobody could block him. He didn't stop until he had sacked Elway in the end zone for a safety. Many say this was the play that turned the game around for the Giants.
I'm glad I was able to help turn the tide in the Super Bowl with that safety. I hope and pray that the Supreme Court has begun to turn the tide against the legalized destruction of babies allowed by the Roe versus Wade decision. That infamous decision said that unborn babies have no rights, just as the shameful Dred Scott decision said that black people have no rights. I hope you will help right this terrible wrong.
It was the perfect call. Second down and six, late in the third quarter, Phil Simms handed off to Joe Morris, who faked into the line before turning and lateraling back to Simms. Simms then fired far downfield to Phil McConkey. McConkey was tackled just shy of the end zone.
All my life, I dreamt of scoring a touchdown in the Super Bowl, and at that moment, I thought sure I'd lost my chance. But later, in the fourth quarter, I got another chance, and my lifelong dream was realized. I've always said, as long as you have life in you, you've got a chance. Unfortunately, when you take the life of a baby by abortion, it will never have a chance.
Morris not only led all runners in the Super Bowl, he outrushed the whole Bronco team. A good part of the reason was the blocking of Chris Godfrey. Here he is throwing the key block that allows Joe to score.
That touchdown in the third period really put the Broncos in a hole. It had increased our lead to more than two touchdowns. It took only 20 seconds to run that play and killed any chance they had in that game. In that same 20 seconds, an American baby was killed by abortion. Every 20 seconds of every minute, of every hour, of every day, since Roe versus Wade, over 25 million American babies have been killed. One every 20 seconds.
Led by the brilliant record-setting passing performance of Phil Sims, the Giants rallied from a 10-9 halftime deficit for a record 30-point second half on their way to a smashing Super Bowl victory. Sims was a torrid 22 of 25 for 268 yards and three touchdowns. He not only set an all-time Super Bowl record of 88% completions, but an all-time NFL playoff record as well. For his super efforts, Sims was a landslide MVP winner.
When I woke up the next morning and read those statistics in the paper, I was very pleased and proud. But there was another statistic in the paper that morning that didn't get the same coverage the Super Bowl got. I guess they thought it wasn't very important. It was just a little item that stated there are an average of 4,400 babies killed every day by abortion, or about 1,600,000 killed every year. Suddenly, my statistics seemed very insignificant.
One of the scenes that will remain permanently etched in the minds and the hearts of everyone who saw this Super Bowl. The love between a father and his son.
Winning the Super Bowl was one of the two top things that happened in my life. Here's number one.
I love you, Dad. It's great to be alive.
The child needs special safeguards and care, including appropriate legal protection before as well as after birth. Preamble, United Nations Declaration on Rights of the Child. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. United States Declaration of Independence. One of every three pregnancies is ended by abortion. If the abortionists had their way, which two of these giants might never have had the chance to be champions? Those whose voices will prevail are those who offer a message. People who would put an end to the slaughter of unborn children have the best message in the world. Life itself. These people are the true champions. Champions for life.
If you would like to obtain your own VHS copy of Champions for Life, just send a check for $10 to the American Life League, Post Office Box 1350, Stafford, Virginia, 22554.